Hi guys, I wanted to make a second video about Telemachus Argon. I think the promotional video said almost everything of the things you want to know about Telemachus Argon. Just one, two more things that are special to my opinion, because you want to take the best of your Telemachus Argon without any problems. The first thing, I mentioned it already on promotional video, is that you have to fill with liquid up to the upper point of the slot of the armor. Not like Telemachus version 2, where you fill it up to the top of the plastic, because if you do that on Telemachus armed, the pressure of the air well is pressuring the liquid inside. When you put the cap back on, the small leakage will go inside between the armor and the clear tank, so maybe you will see the clear tank a little wet. To avoid this, just fill it up to here. The second and most important, to my opinion, is how you can put the wick. You know that the Telemachus is an atomizer that drives you exactly the right way to make the resistance, the wick, and all the stuff. It has two slots. When you make your wire, make your wire around a metal rod. Don't see that rod, it's made of wood, because I will put just a spring. I will not make a wire right now, because to speak the truth, I have forget how to make wires after the springomizer. Anyway, you will it drives you exactly to make your wire, and now it drives you exactly how to make your wick. What I mean, let's put first of all the resistance inside, and now we will put the wick, and I will tell you how you can cut it, because in atomizers, you see sometimes you face the difficulty on how long I will leave from the right or the left side. I left a lot of it. It can't go inside the channels or inside the deck and all this stuff. Now, let's make a wick and put it inside the spring, and now look how we can cut it. First of all, I will touch with scissors the base, and then I will do this to make the scissors touch the rebuildable part, and I will cut carefully. I do the same from this side, touch here, and then touch here, and cut. This is the remaining wick from side to side, and we will make it fluffy. This is the part I want you to see, because when you cut with scissors, the wick becomes thin. We want to be fluffy because the feeding channels of Telemachus arm are big, and we don't need any leakage. We want the wick to fill all the place of the feeding channels. Now, as you see, the wick is fluffy. This is good not only because it covers the feeding channels, but also because it is fluffy, so its absorption it absorbs much better the liquid. You see it that it is long enough. And if we put the mouthpiece on it, the mouthpiece will not close correctly. So, just put a little from here, from the base, to the base of the channels. Just put the wick inside to the base, not here, up to the base only. Not all of it, just a little. Just a little, so when the mouthpiece close, the wick will not stay out of the end of the mouthpiece. I don't prime it. I only prime the center, because I want and I'm priming the wick to sit exactly where it wants to sit, because priming the wick will make it thin and wick will not sit exactly where we want. Close it, make one, two turns clockwise or counterclockwise, just to make the wick sit well, and that's it. This is exactly the best way, to my opinion. I have tried a lot of setups. This works the best for me. For my sellers that have tested, they have other techniques. My technique by putting inside the deck the wick is working very well for them. Anyway, I am telling you my experience. If you want to try different styles, it's okay. But I have to tell you what works for me to be sure that you will not face any problems. That's all about Telemachos. As I said, the rest of the most serious information is on the promotional video. We can discuss more things after you try it by yourself. Thanks a lot for watching. Have a great day. Bye.